Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, our Provider, our Maker, and our Protector, through your goodness we are alive and healthy enough to gather and to worship you. We praise you for all that you have given us and thank you in Jesus' name. Holy Lord, we commit all our good deeds to you and ask that everything we do be done for your glory forever and ever. Heavenly Lord, your name is glorious and wonderful. You are the King of all, and we worship you, our Lord. We gather in your presence in the unity of our faith to ask that you bless us. Without your power and grace, we can do nothing. We pray that your glory continues to fill and radiate within our lives so that we can be your ambassadors to the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us follow the order of service. Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment, and the second is like it, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us, and write all these thy laws in our hearts, we beseech thee." Collect for the day. Life-saving faith. Let us pray. O God, the author of our life, you have called us to be dynamic and active, to connect together to create life-saving networks. Give us life-saving faith to become friends to the needy, support the weak, comfort the sick, and be channels of your healing. Empower us to be committed to the needs of the little ones around us, and bring our fellow humans to your space so that we may be transformed as useful instruments in your healing hands. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Let us hear the scripture readings.
Second lesson is taken from 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 1 to 7. The wife of a man from the company of the prophets cried out to Elisha, "Your servant, my husband, is dead, and you know that he revered the Lord. But now his creditor is coming to take my two boys and as his slaves." Elisha replied to her, "How can I help you? Tell me, what do you have in your house?" "Your sons, pour oil into all the jars, and as each is filled, put it to one side." She left him and shut the door behind her and her sons. They brought the jars to her, and she kept pouring. When all the jars were full, she said to her son, "Bring me another one." But he replied, "There is no jar left." Then the oil stopped flowing. She went and told the man of God, and he said, "Go sell the oil and pay your debts. You and your sons can live on what is left." One day Elisha went to Shunem, and a well-to-do woman was there, who urged him to stay for a meal. So whenever he came by, he stopped there to eat. She said to her husband, "I know that this man who often comes our way is a holy man of God. Let's make a small room on a roof and put it in a bed and a table, a chair and a lamp for him. Then he can stay there whenever he comes to us." One day when Elisha came, he went up to his room and laid low. Here ends the Bible reading.
The second Bible reading is taken from Acts chapter 5 verses 12 to 16. Acts chapter 5 verses 12 to 16. Now many signs and wonders were regularly done among the people by the acts of the apostles. And they were all together in Solomon's portico. Now of the rest that joined them, but the people held them in high esteem. And more than ever, believers were added to the Lord, multitudes of both men and women, so that they even carried out the sick into the streets and laid them on cots and mats, that as Peter came by, at least his shadow might fall on some of them. The people also gathered from the town around Jerusalem, bringing the sick and those afflicted with unclean spirits, and they were all held. Here ends the second Bible reading.
Let us all stand for the responsive reading. The responsive reading is taken from Psalm chapter 72. Psalm 72. Give the king thy judgments, O God, and thy righteousness unto the king's son. Your response. The mountains shall bring peace to the people, and the little hills by righteousness. Your response? They shall fear thee as long as the sun and the moon endure throughout all generations. Your response? In his days shall the righteous flourish, and abundance of peace so long as the moon endureth. Your response?
May the Lord dominion from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth.
They that dwell in the wilderness shall bow before him, and his enemies shall lick the dust. Your response?
May the kings of Tarshish and the
Yea, all kings shall fall down before him, all nations shall serve him. Your response? He shall spare the poor and needy, and shall save the souls of the needy. Your response?
From oppression and violence he redeems their life, and teaches the blood in his sight.
And he shall live, and to him shall be given of the gold of Sheba. Prayer also shall be made for him continually, and daily shall he be praised. Your response?
May there be abundance of rain in the land, on the tops of the mountains may go be Lebanon, and be faithful blossom in the cities like the grass.
His name shall endure forever. His name shall be continued as long as the sun, and men shall be blessed in him. All nations shall come to him, be blessed. Your response?
Blessed be the Lord, the God of his name, for all his wondrous things.
And blessed be his glorious name forever, and let the whole earth be filled with his glory. Amen and amen. Let us say together, the prayers of David, the son of Jesse, are ended. Here ended the responsive reading.
Hear the word of God as it is written in the Gospel according to St. Luke chapter 5, beginning at verse 17 to 26. gospel reading, St. Luke chapter 5, beginning at verse 17. On one of those days, as he was teaching, Pharisees and teachers of the law were sitting there, who had come from every village of Galilee and Judea and from Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was with him to heal. And behold, some men were bringing on a bed a man who was paralyzed, and they were seeking to bring him in and lay him before Jesus. But finding no way to bring him in because of the crowd, they went up on the roof and let him down with his bed through the tiles into the midst before Jesus. And when he saw their faith, he said, "Man, your sins are forgiven you." And the scribes and the Pharisees began to question, saying, "Who is this who speaks blasphemies? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" When Jesus perceived their thoughts, he answered them, "Why do you question in your hearts? Which is easier, to say your sins are forgiven you, or to say, rise and walk? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the man who was paralyzed, "I said to you, rise, pick up your bed and go home." And immediately he rose up before them and picked up what he had been lying on and went home glorifying God. And amazement chased them all, and they glorified God and were filled with awe, saying, "We have seen extraordinary things today." After this, he went out and saw a tax collector named Levi sitting at the tax booth, and he said to him, "Follow me." And leaving everything, he rose and followed him. Here ends the gospel reading. Let us profess our faith by singing Nicene Creed. Remain standing, let us sing hymn number 192. Hymn number 192. Is praying. Loving and gracious Father, we thank you and praise you for this last day of this month. Lord, we thank you and praise you for all the gifts, blessings and miracles in our own life. Lord, we are in your presence. We are longing for your word. We are longing for your knowledge and wisdom. Help us and guide us to have the appropriate approach to get the appropriate meaning of your word. Lord, help us and guide us to realize the presence of the Holy Spirit as we are meditating upon your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please be seated. Dear friends, I greet you all in the name of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. By the grace of God, we are in the last day of this month, February. Tomorrow, if God willing, we will be entering into the new month, in which also we will be giving much importance to our own Lenten understanding and to explicit our own life in the way of cross. The theme for today's meditation is life-saving faith. Life-saving faith. In general, in our life, faith is so important. Without faith, we cannot do anything. Then we should know the definition of faith. Recently, one of the educational officers asked his teacher about faith in a school. She said, faith is on God. Faith is the Father God. Faith is on the Creator. This is what the teacher explicited. Immediately, the educational officer asked one of the students. She was regular to the Sunday school. She used to be in the vacation Bible school of the nearby church. She openly said, "Sir, let me want to tell you the definition of faith." Then the educational officer asked that little girl, "What is faith?" She said, "Faith is F-A-I-T-H. This is faith. For me, let me want to give the expansion, definition of faith." After that she said, "For all, I trust him, that is faith." Faith, F-A-I-T-H. For all, I trust him. This is what the girl explicited to the educational officer. For all, I trust him. Today, being a Christian, we need to have our own self-examination about our own faith on our own Creator. We are in the Lenten season. Tomorrow we will be entering into a new month. In that context, in this Lenten season, we should have self-examination about our own faith. Saving faith is a matter of life and death. Faith leads to life and death of our own life. A strong conviction of truth is faith. A strong conviction of truth is faith. You should have your own conviction. You should know the truth, then you should have conviction, that is faith. So faith is a strong conviction of truth. On the other side, during these Lenten days, our faith should be a personal surrender to Creator. Faith leads to a personal surrender in our own life. If you are giving much importance to faith on God, you will personally surrender yourself to God and you will give much importance to the cross of our Lord Jesus and you will take up your own cross in your own life. On the other side, there is another definition for faith. A lifelong process of sanctification. You should give much importance to your own holiness. If you want to be very whole in your own integrity, you should maintain the code of holiness. That is what our scripture explicits. If you are having faith, you will maintain everything according to the holiness code of our own God. So, lifelong process of sanctification is faith. Another important thing is, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Without faith, you cannot please God. So we are in this Lenten season. We need to think about our own faith. If you are pleasing God, you are in faith on God. There are four components of saving faith. If you are giving much importance to faith, there are four components. We are saved by faith. In that, we have four components. The first component is understanding. In faith, we should have our own understanding. The second one is, if you are having faith, you will have acknowledgement. Understanding, acknowledgement. The third one is obedience. Fourth one is total trust. There are four components. First one is understanding. The second one is acknowledgement. The third one is obedience. The fourth one is trust. If you are having faith on God, you will have these four components as your own quality. That quality will make you to have quantitative life in a different way, in a significant way. There are people who are coming regular to the church. There are people who are very regular to the worship without faith. As a tradition, as a ritual, they are maintaining everything in their own spiritual life. But today, we should have these four components. Then only our faith is meaningful. Once again, let me want to remind you about those four components. One is understanding. You should have very good understanding about God. The second one is acknowledgement. After understanding, you need to explicit your own acknowledgement thing. You will give much importance to the word of God alone, not the word of the world, not the word of the flesh, but you will give importance to the word of God. So obedience is another important quality. The fourth one is real total trust. You will totally on God only. There is independence, there is interdependence. In faith, you will see the independence as well as interdependence. So faith is so important. That is why we see in the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 24, verse 13, but the one who endures to the end, he will be saved. But the one who endures to the end, till the end, we should maintain our own faith. Whatever we have, whatever trouble, whatever problem, whatever impediments we have in our own life, we need to give much importance to our own faith. Faith comes to the believer as a gift from God. If you are giving much importance to your own faith, that is the gift from God. Another theologian says about faith, he says, the dynamic faith involves in intellect, emotions and the will. In the dynamic faith, you can see your own intellectual reflection. You will see something emotional. You will see the willpower also. Today, we need to think about a lady who was a widow, who lost everything. She was about to have something different for her own life. She had two sons that also give from me money from that point. Let me want to show this Kings 4th chapter verse 1, where the author says about that lady. She was a widow. She had two sons, but she was not in a position to have her own sons with her because she received money from a person. That person is pressurizing her to give those two sons as his own slaves. This is the situation she was facing. No money, no resources. She was suffering a lot. There was a difficult position. As a lady, she cried. If you happen to read that verse in that Old Testament unit, where we can see the lady's broken heart. She was in a miserable condition. She was in her lowest moment. She suffered a lot. So we see the difficult position of that lady. She says the death of her husband, and she quotes something different about the life of her own husband. She says, we are the family of a prophet. We are a family of a prophet. We gave much importance to the word of God. Now we are suffering. Now we are having something different in our own life. There is no future for us. Our future is very dark. But we are expressing the truth. We are the people of God. Today, we may be in a difficult position. We will be having something different as our own position in the future. But here comes the question of our own faith. The little girl said, for all I trust him. What is faith? For all I trust God alone. Whatever comes to my own life, we need to give much importance to the God alone. Here she faced death. She faced debt. And she was about to lose her own two sons because there was a threat from a person. But she was known for her own devotion in her family. She was devoted to God alone. She was very particular about his own claim, in which they are giving much importance to the attachment with God. They had very good affinity with God. Life of devotion to the Lord. In our context, we may be having difficult position as our own life, but we need to give much importance to our own faith. So the first point we receive from this widow is difficult position. She had trouble and trial in her own life. The second point that we want to share with you about this unit is divine prescription. The first point is difficult position. The second point is divine prescription. The lady, the widow, received something different from the prophet Elisha. Elisha was the disciple of Elijah. They were known in the society as the people of God, man of God. They were instructed by God and they gave very constructive direction to the people of God. Those who followed the direction of the prophet, they had very good construction as their own construction. They had very perfection as their own life. Here, Elisha was physically present in this context. She was expliciting about her own difficult position. Immediately, we can see the divine prescription. The prophet asked the widow, what you need, what do you have? What you need, what do you have? Or what do you want me to do? This is what the question the prophet asked the widow. Here the question is so important. The prophet plays his own role as a responsible person of God. He sees something different in her own life, but she was expliciting about her own attachment with God. She was devoted to God. Immediately, the prophet questioned, what do you want me to do? What do you have? These two questions are very important. Our God gives much importance to our own faith. She says, I am about to lose my own two sons. Everything was explicited openly by that widow. But the prophet is so particular of asking these two questions. What do you have? What do you want me to do? Today, this is very community-oriented questions. This is a question which leads to corporate life. She says, I am not having anything. Just oil, fill up a pot. A jar of oil is available. No other thing is available. Here we see the expansion of faith. In this divine prescription, we see the expansion of faith because she openly uttered such a statement, a pot of oil is available. A pot of oil
something different in that context. She was explaining about her own difficult position. Here we see the divine prescription. The prophet made two questions. What do you have? What do you want me to do? Here we see the expansion of faith. The expansion is very personal, very personal. Personally, she uttered such a statement, I am having just a pot of oil. Then the faith expands publicly for the public affair. The prophet says, you go and bring vessels. You borrow vessels from your own neighbor because you are having only a pot of oil. Just a pot you are having it. You are having very minimum number of vessels in your own life. So you borrow from others, from neighbors. Here we see the expansion publicly. It is known to the public. She was asking to the friends and the neighbors, borrow all the empty vessels. This is very important. Borrow all the empty vessels. You just borrow all the empty vessels from your friends and neighbors. This is the divine prescription. Nothing is there. You cannot say there is something, but here nothing is there. The prophet says, you borrow all the vessels, empty vessels. Today, in our Lenten season, we should make ourselves as empty vessel. We should empty ourselves. Then only we can have the Lenten season in a meaningful way. So the first point is difficult position. The second point is divine prescription. The third point is divine presentation. That is demonstration, divine demonstration. What happens? They had only a pot of oil, a jar of oil. But here, she borrowed all the vessels from friends, relatives, neighbors. Everything was fulfilled, overflowing. Something different happens. When you are giving importance to your own faith on God, you will have overflowing blessings in your own life. That is what the gospel says. Give importance to the kingdom of God. You will receive something different. You will get added blessings in your own life. This is what the direction we receive. Today, we need to think about our own life in this Lenten season. We have given much importance to so many Lenten seasons in our own life. But this year is something different, because we were in the pandemic situation. By the grace of God only, we are alive. See, there are so many ministers, there are so many VIPs, there are so many people not with us today. But God has given us life to us. We need to think about our own involvement in this Lenten season. In what way we are approaching God? What is our faith? A little girl said, for all I trust in. Today, whom we are trusting, whom we are giving importance. Here we see a widow lady. She had a difficult position, but she received divine prescription, divine presentation. You can see the demonstration of divinity in her life. If you are having very good faith, you will see the demonstration of divinity in your own life. Today, we should have such an enjoyment as our own Lenten exercise. Dear friends, a student asked the professor of theology, sir, let me want to get a clear picture about Lent. What is Lent? The professor of theology said, you go and bring a coconut from the coconut tree. The student went and brought one coconut to the professor of theology. Then the professor asked the student, can you give the description? Can you explain about this coconut fruit? He was struggling to explain about the fruit of the coconut tree. Then he said, see the coconut tree fruit, in that there is outer skin. There is outer skin. After that outer skin, you can see the choir, that fiber-oriented material. After that, you can see the shell. After that only, you can get the seed coat and water, sweet water. There are so many steps you should adapt to have your own Lenten season in a meaningful way. He was not in a position to understand the explanation of the professor of theology. Immediately he said, it is easy to remove the outer skin. By having white and white as your own uniform, you can say, I am very holy. By your dress, you can have such a expansion or explanation. But you should go further. There is choir. In that, you can see something different. You should remove that also. After that, you can see a ordering part of that fruit shell that should be broken. Then only you can see the main part of that fruit and the sweet water. Like that, in the Lenten season, you need to remove so many things in your own life. But we people are not giving importance in that manner. We are giving importance to non-vegetarian, removing our own style of living in a different way. We are not giving importance to flowers. This is how we are making up everything. But what the God wants is, we need to have something different. We need to have remove all the things which is ordering towards faith on God. Dear friends, a widow, she made something different in her own life. She had a difficult position. Today we may be in a difficult situation. We may be suffering, but we need to give much importance to God. So we have seen three important points from this Old Testament unit. The first point is difficult position. The second point is divine prescription. The third point is divine presentation. That is the demonstration of divinity. May God bless these verses. Amen. Announcements to the members of the congregation. Greetings and welcome to all our members and friends. Tomorrow, the first day of March, as usual, we will be having our worship at 7 a.m. On Wednesday, 3rd March 2021, there will be a Lenten devotional service at 6:30 p.m. in the evening. All are requested to come. Next Sunday, 28th, we will be having all the spiritual exercise of our pastorate election. From today onwards, we will be involving in announcements of the pastorate committee election. Sunday service collection, that is last Sunday. General collection, ₹2,850. Subscription, ₹2,550. Thanks offering, ₹800. Wednesday service, ₹590. Total, ₹7,320. So far, those who are not received the Lenten undies, kindly get it from our sexton. Pastorate committee election announcements. Preliminary roll is published today, that is 28th February 2021. Representation, if any, for the electoral roll, 3rd March 2021, before 6 p.m. should be given in writing. Last PC meeting, 3rd March 2021. Final electoral roll will be published on the 7th March 2021, that is according to the process of the election, second Sunday. Nomination filing, 7th March 2021. Last day for filing nomination, 10th March 2021 before 6 p.m. that is on Wednesday. Valid nominations will be published on the 11th March 2021 Thursday at 6 p.m. Withdrawal of nomination 13th March 2021 Saturday before 6 p.m. Final list of valid nomination will be published on the 14th March 2021 that is Sunday, third Sunday of the election process. PC election will be held on the 21st March 2021, that is fourth Sunday of the election process. Kindly pray for the spiritual exercise of our Pashit Committee election. Members who are celebrating birthdays in this week: Mr. Sam Prabhakar Rao, Miss Angela Rebecca Freeman, and Mrs. Pramila Kumar. Let us pray for the members who are celebrating their birthdays in this week. Let us pray. Our loving and gracious Father, we thank you and praise you for the fellowship we enjoy in our congregation. Lord, we pray for our members who are celebrating their birthdays in this week. Bless them and guide them so that they can see the divine demonstration in their own life in this new year. Lord, help them and guide them so that they can have the values of your kingdom in an appropriate way. Give them good life as their own life and make them to have their own involvement in the society according to your own understanding and values. Lord, give them your knowledge and wisdom and grace so that they can have prosperity in this new year. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us pray. Let us follow the order of worship. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's Church militant here on earth. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers, supplications, and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers which we offer. Inspire continually the universal Church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and that all who confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee to lead all nations in the way of righteousness and peace, and so guide their rulers that thy people may be justly and quietly governed. We especially remember our president, the prime minister, the governor of the state, and all in authority under them. Give grace, O heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, that by their life and doctrine they may set forth thy true and life-giving word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. Unto all thy people give thy heavenly grace. Grant that this congregation may hear and receive thy holy word, and truly serve thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all who are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, and or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear. Give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. You that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins, are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy days, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, meekly kneeling upon your knees. Let us say the confession prayer to our Almighty Father. Almighty God, Father of Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, working most justly thereof, and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are deeply sorry for this our history. The remembrance of them is grievous to us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, that thy Son of the Holy
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of His great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto Him. Our mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all that truly turn to Him. Come unto me, all that are heavily laden, and I will refresh you. God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, to the end that all believe in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. There is true saying, unworthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and He is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto Thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we loud and magnify Thy glorious name, evermore praising Thee and saying, let us say the humble access prayer. Let us say together, we do not presume to come to this Thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in Thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under Thy table, but Thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of Thy dear Son Jesus Christ and drink His blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by His body and our souls washed through His most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in Him and He is in us. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank Thee that Thou dost vouchsafe to feed us with the spiritual food of the most precious body, blood of Thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby Thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are members incorporate in the mystical body of Thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of Thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of the most precious death and passion of Thy dear Son. We most humbly beseech Thee, O Heavenly Father, to assist us with Thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as Thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with Thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Let us sing the Gloria together.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the blessings of life and death. We thank you for our own interest in which we see the direction of our own God. Thank you for allowing us to have the opportunity to be in your presence again today. We come together with the unity of our faith and ask that everything we bind be bound in heaven. Allow everything we lose be loosed in heaven. Together we will compact the evil that gathers and ask that evil doers be confronted. May their plans always come to naught. Bless us so that we may leave here today with your spiritual blessings. Our Heavenly Father, we have come to the end of the worship and we want to thank you for enabling us to be here from the beginning to the end. Thank you for teaching and touching our lives in a ways we cannot explain. You have taken us to your realms of glory and we want to say thank you. As we depart to our homes and various destinations, we ask you to continue being with us. Let your spirit see us through. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of your Son Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be among us you and remain with you always.